how many times have you deployed an AI agent only to wonder, what is your agent actually doing in production? Today, we're going to show you how to get visibility into your AI agents built with Strands Agents SDK and your agents that are deployed into production so that you can get complete visibility into your agent's behavior and performance.
When we talk about observability, there are three fundamental questions that every developer faces when building and deploying AI agents. How do I trust my agents? How do I address performance bottleneck and errors? Are the agents making the right decision? Without proper observability, you are essentially deploying AI agents blindly. You cannot debug error, optimize performance, or demonstrate business value. This is why observability is an absolute imperative for being able to deploy agents to production with confidence.
So let us give you a quick demo of the solution. You'll see how easy it is to get started with AgentCore Observability. While I'm going to show you observability for Strands agents today, you can use AgentCore Observability with other agentic frameworks as well. I'm on my laptop here and I've pulled up the AWS console. Right from within the AgentCore Observability dashboard, I'm able to see very detailed information in terms of insights that are derived from sampled spans across these agents. I can also see very detailed information in terms of where those agents are deployed, which environment. And then I can also see detailed information in terms of the latency associated with each of those agents. Let's take a deeper look now into the web search agents that's deployed and built on Strands. So in this web search Strands agent, I can see a detailed overview of key metrics associated with this agent, including the number of sessions, the traces, and detailed information by span. If this agent was deployed on AgentCore runtime, I would also be able to see detailed information in terms of the total sessions, the invocations, and the latency. Now let's take a look at deeper information in terms of the sessions associated with this agent. I'm gonna click here to view the specific session ID. So I'm gonna take a look at the specific trace for a specific agent and a session. And this brings up a very detailed dashboard which shows me a timeline associated with this particular web search agent, the specific trajectories and workflows that this agent took, and I can see very detailed information in terms of the web search agent session, the specific event loop cycle that was executed, that this agent completed a web search tool. And I can also see that a chat was initiated and that this agent leveraged Anthropic Claude to complete the response. There's even more detailed information with regards to the specific spans and events that are associated with this agent session.
So the very first question that I would have when I'm looking at observability is, what was the user question? Then what did my agent do to solve that question? And how was the result of a tool or a database was used to generate a final response that was shared with the user? So in this case, I'm going to look at the model call here. I have detailed data on span, but in this specific case, I'm interested in understanding, hey, what was my user input? So user is asking about, hey, tell me a list of best restaurants in New York City in Midtown. Then there are my agent instructions. And then in this final view, we can see the agent decided to make a web search call. Now, in order to see what happened during web search, you can look at the web search responses. So you have your span data here. And since I wanted to do a custom implementation to be able to have more granular information, I have implemented a custom web search logging, where I can see the exact URL from where this search was performed, the search results itself, and so on and so forth. Finally, it is very important for our developers to know how was the data used in order to generate the response that was shared with the user. So I'm going to go in the events for my last LLM call here, and as I can also see the latency for this specific action. So we have a series of operations, but I'm right now interested in the tool message, which would give me the response of the tool. And then finally, once I have all of that, I see that my agent intelligently used it to generate this response, which was shared with the user.
So Ishan, how do you actually go about configuring this?
To use AgentCore Observability for your Strands agent or for any other framework, all you need to do is to first enable your transaction search in your CloudWatch, And then after that, you just configure certain environment variables so that your environment knows to send the traces, logs, and metrics to CloudWatch. As you can see, this is your regular agent code. There is nothing specific you need to do here. Finally, we auto-instrument this code using the AWS OpenTelemetry Python distro library. And when you run your agent, you only need to associate or add OpenTelemetry instrument right before it. That's it. There is no other setup.
Now, go build something awesome with any framework, any model with AgentCore Observability. Head to the AgentCore Observability documentation page on Amazon Bedrock to get started. We've also put links below to our sample code on GitHub. We can't wait to see what you build.